Hi everyone, my name is Sveta Smirnova and I work as my school support engineer for more than 12 years. 12 years. I started in my school AB and then this company was acquired and currently I work for Percona. And I'm here to answer your questions and let's see what I have now. First is question is in your talk you showed dozens of options which improve my school performance. Does this mean DBA position is dead and everyone can perfectly tune my school performance? Well, the answer is yes or no. Sorry, I don't see my I'm sorry, I'm talking with our host, Cassandra, because for some reason I don't see myself. Anyway, let's back to the question. It's actually answer is yes or no. And my school DBA position is certainly is not dead because my school is complicated software and you need to perfectly tune it. You need to understand how it works. But at the same time, in my talk, I showed these options which could solve like kind of 80% of performance issues. And this is actually like the first thing which we in support try to check if if our customers report performance issues. But this kind of 80% which could be solved by tuning these options, that's not all the options which can cause to my school slowdown, and of course my school DBA position is still will be alive. Okay, so I see do not see more questions and do we have other questions? Another question is what are perspectives of the automatic database configuration? For example, configuration made by the server itself without human intervention. My school world, I think once I started in Percona in 2015 and on Percona Live, I saw many, Percona Live is yearly conferences about which my employer provides about databases. And on these conferences, we regularly saw talk from various companies or even institutions, universities, who try to perform automatic MySQL configuration. Last year, I also saw it's Oracle Open World. It's a conference which Oracle company provides and also has MySQL part of it because Oracle now owns MySQL as product. They presented its own software working in cloud about which allows to configure MySQL automatically. So this is certainly it's a growing market for it. But at the same time, methods which such solution use is like learning. So like they take live database. Software tries to change options. It tries to measure how effective is it. And while test shows perfect results, like having some benchmarks which run firstly, it's initially started as like with default option started to run slow and then it start to perform very fast. It's not something which you want to see on production. Like for example, if you are having trouble, you are having the trouble, you want to resolve it quickly, and this is why knowledge of experienced people comes in. But at the same time, certainly this approach works, and probably since some few iterations, we will have working solution when server can tune itself. At the same time, I can also say that MySQL supports for years automatic configuration. Like, for example, in a DB storage engine, can use its own algorithms to decide when to flush pages from the buffer pool, when it decides that server is idle and it can perform more background work, and then server is active, it tries to perform less background work. So that's happens, that's growing, that's going on, but this is not well, it's I think it's something which could be done better in future. Question is, can you tell how you got involved working in open source? Well, actually, that's I started my IT career as a web developer. And as web developer, I tried to use working with open source products just because I liked it. And probably that's because that's it started my IT career in beginning of this beginning of millennium of 2000 years, and that's was most democratic options which available for most of my customers. And when I worked on open source projects, I got them for free. I got source code. I could modify it. I could read like. I'm having, even if I didn't modify, I found like it's working not as I expected. I could read the source, I could read, use bug databases, and I could implement workaround based on the my knowledge. And then I once said, I started to working about like, how I can return back. And sites like open source projects, which is was PHP, the programming languages, MySQL and PostgreSQL databases, it's not the it was written in C and C++, and that's not like my area of expertise. I tried to contribute to PHP documentation. I tried to contribute to forum to share knowledge, and this way it's how I was involved. And my friend then asked me to join MySQL support team, and I joined MySQL support team and started to work in open source professionally. Okay, thank you. More questions? On which platforms MySQL shows better performance? MySQL, it's well, it's a hard question speaking about like how I work it in like in MySQL and working now in Percona and supporting new platform, even if it's Linux, it's well, it's a little bit challenged because like different versions of Linux have special something special libraries, like something which can cannot work perfectly like on other platforms. And it's like if you go to download page for MySQL and Percona server, you will see just like a limited number of platforms. And I would say these nine platforms were performance teams on these companies, they put their effort to tune MySQL software better. Speaking about which exactly platforms which is the best, it's I would say go to Percona site because we support like Debian and Red Hat like Debian, Ubuntu, and Red Hat, CentOS, Fedora. Version of Linux, and the test MySQL on these platforms. Oracle supports more platforms, and MariaDB also supports more platforms. But I can say, like, for the most focus and most user base and most shops to use, that's either Red Hat or Debian kind of Linux. For other flavors of Linux, MySQL should work and should work perfectly, but you may see some issues when you compile MySQL on these platforms. Thank you. Okay, do we have more questions or I'm done? Okay, thank you very much. I will be around on the chat, and if you have more questions, you can ask me. Feel free to ask me. Feel free to ping me. At the end of my presentation, I also put link to my Twitter account. Also, feel free to write me on Twitter and ask any questions you like. I have one more question. Is what has been the best piece of advice you have ever received? Oh, that's tough questions. It's hard to answer without preparing. Well, it's actually I would say maybe it's like not the best, but it's speaking like about MySQL performance. It's the best piece of advice which I heard lately about MySQL performance is from Dmitry Skravchuk. He is a performance architect at MySQL team at Oracle, and he tests all new versions of MySQL for better performance. He uses complicated and standard test sets and finds like when code goes wrong, but still he says that's best benchmark is your production. And I believe that's it. It's actually that's what I am telling my customers all the time we hit a performance issue because it's really depends on the load. What do you consider your greatest success in your career? Well, it's probably it's the fact which I joined my school support team and I'm still here. And why it's success? It's because I sometimes to try to do something different because I get bored. And at the same time, maybe I will need just 1 hour. Some customer comes in and asks me questions, which I just cannot answer, and I have to learn something new. So that's why it's really fun and challenging work. What do you love about working in open source? It's I love. It's actually I like the fact that with open source. It's few things. First, like we are giving something which like we are doing our world better. We are doing something good and giving that away for free. It's also I like that we can share knowledge. We can learn anything with like like we can take a source code. We can read it. We can refine, understand why it doesn't work. As we expect, or why does it like work so beautifully if we find that's works perfect. And it's again like it's I started my work in open source, not as the open source like a developer or support engineer, but as open source user. And it was very convenient because like when you work with closed source, and that's something that works not as you expect. You cannot do anything with open source. You can just change it. You can understand it. You can submit a bug report. You can contribute. You have many options how to make its software to work better for you. Thank you very much. It was a pleasure to talk on Open Source Summit, and thank you very much for inviting me. Thank you.